issue of the horn is not simply about giving food to the Somali children. That is important. We now have to save lives in the horn. But you know, this crisis has not come as a tsunami. It has not come as a surprise. We have known about this crisis for the last 6 months. This is not the first time it has happened in the horn, and I don't think it is the last time it will happen. I think the best contribution we could make today is to say, let us save lives in the horn, but let us work together for the stability and ensuring that the Horn of Africa does not see this tragedy in the coming years. And that begins by political action by African people themselves on Somalia. This is the longest crisis on the African continent. And I think it has begun with us resolving that issue. That's the first point. Number two, I think I see my friend Bob Zorgia's counsel, I leave him to develop that later. Someone has said over the last 30 years there have been two major events which have redefined the world. The collapse of the Berlin Wall and the collapse of the Lehman Brothers. And as in between, the world is quite different. And so the Society for International Development has had an agenda over this period of time, which is absolutely fantastic. I think I've done a great job in terms of advocacy for what the world could do for Africa. That was the problem. It was, what can we do for Africa? I think the new terrain is saying two things. First of all, it is unlikely that the rich world suffering fiscal retrenchment, unemployment, can generate the resources we need for the kind of investments we have to make. But there is a new terrain which gives the whole architecture possibilities. And I think the new agenda for the SID could be, how do we get Africa to converge with the rest of the world, to unlock its own potential, taking advantage of all these possibilities now which are open in the world, which are domestic, which are regional, which are international. I think in that agenda you'll find Africans working with you instead of the international community doing something for the Africans. And you'll find that it's an agenda which will be most welcome on my continent. Again, I want to end by saying that what happens on my continent in terms of sustainability, we largely depend upon what we do, we Africans. Rule of law, stable institutions, institutions that work for all, creating confidence for investors, African investors, and foreign investors, and I welcome you to join us in that agenda.
Thank you very much indeed. I know you clapped, but can we now formally give a huge clap to our two panelists for